problem is to write a Python program to check if a number is prime or not. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will be learning how to check if a number is prime or not. So guys, since our childhood we have been learning about the prime numbers. Today what we will be doing, we will be creating a program in Python which will allow us to check if a number is prime or not. Let's have a look on how it can be done. Before we start creating a program, let's first know that what are prime numbers. Like most of you might know what are prime numbers, but some of you are still there who don't know. First of all, let's understand what are prime numbers. So as I was talking about prime numbers are the numbers that are divisible by themselves only, or they are divisible by 1. That means, let's say if I take an example of 11. The number 11 is not divisible by 2. That means when you divide it by 2, it does not give you the remainder 0, or it does not come in a table of 2. It does not come in a table of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And it only comes in a table of 11, and it only comes in a table of 1 over here, right? So 1 we will not be considering, but all the numbers that comes in a table of themselves or of 1 are called as prime numbers. Another example could be 13. 13 only comes in a table of 13. But what about 15? 15 comes in a table of 3. It comes in a table of 5. And it also comes in a table of itself, that is 15. So it comes in a table of 3 numbers, right? That means 15 is not a prime number. Now that we know what are prime numbers, let's understand that how we will be creating a program in Python. Let's understand the logic that we will be using in Python. So I'll be taking the example of number 11 only over here. Let's take the example of number 11 only and let's see how it can be done. So our first condition, suppose if we have taken an input from the user, that number is the input from a user, that is 11, right? Now what do we need to check if it is prime or not? For that, first condition that we will give over here is that number should be greater than 1. Then only it can be a prime number, right? That all the numbers which are greater than 1. So what we are saying over here is that a number should be greater than 1. That means all the numbers that are below 1 are not a prime number. 1 or below 1 are not a prime number. So the prime number starts from number 2. Okay. Now next, what we need to do, we need to iterate in a range that if a number, like if number is greater, so we will be writing if the number is greater than 2, we'll be writing if a number is greater than 1, in that condition what should happen, right? So if condition we will be using over here, that if number is greater than 1, in that condition we will be iterating through for loop, that for I in range. Why we are using for loop over here? Because we need to check over here in a range that if it is a multiple of any other number or not. So suppose if I go from 2, because 1 cannot be considered as a prime number, so we will be starting our range from 2, as all the numbers can be multiplied with 1, so we'll be writing now 2, and the ending number would be 11 over here. We'll be writing 11 colon. Instead of 11, you can also write number. We'll be writing for I in range 2 to number. So what do we need to check in this range? That if number, when divided by I, the I is what? I is a range between 2 to number. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 is the range. And number, that means 11, when divided by 2 gives the remainder 0. In that case, it is not a prime number, right? So we will be printing not prime, else it is a prime number, right? So what is the logic over here? That what we will be doing, we will be iterating in this range and we will be checking with every number that 11, when divided by 2 gives the remainder 0, then it is a prime number, but it is not giving us. So after 11, we'll go to 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then 7, then 8, and then 9, and then 10. So after dividing it by every number, if it is not giving 0 with any number, in that case, it is a prime number. So this logic only we will be using in our program. Let's have a look on how it can be done. So first of all, first thing that we need to do over here is take the input from the user for the number. That number is equals to int. We'll be taking the input in the integers. All the prime numbers are integers. Enter a number here. After this, what I'm going to do, I'm going to give a condition over here that if number is equal to 1. In that case, what we will print it is not a prime number. Because if a number is 1, then definitely it's not a prime number. All the prime numbers starts from the range of 2. Now for starting it from the range of 2, we will be giving another condition that if number is greater than 1, in that condition, what we will be doing, we will be using a for loop over here that for I in range, we'll be iterating through a range that will start with 2 and goes up to the number. So whatever our number is, let's say if it is 11, it goes to up to the 11. And then what it will be checking that if number when divided by I gives the remainder 0, then it is what? It is not a prime number. So we'll be putting a colon over here. Print, it is not a prime number. Because what happens with the prime number, suppose if I take the example of number 12 over here. Number 12 when divided by 2 gives the remainder 0. Number 12 when divided by 3 gives the remainder 0. Number 12 when divided by 6 gives the remainder 0. That means it is not a prime number, right? So it is not a prime number. Else, colon, print, it is a prime number. Now what I will be doing? I'll be running this program. Let's see what happens. Some error will come. I will tell you what error it would be. Suppose if I write 12 over here, it will say it is not a prime number, not a prime number, not a prime number. Then it says it is a prime number. Then it says it is not a prime number. Why this is happening? Because what we need to do is, after writing it is not a prime number, because as soon as number 2 will come, let's say I'm iterating it for 12, right? 12 when divided by 2 gives the remainder 0. Now it will move for next one, that 12 when divided by 3 again gives the remainder 0. So what we need to do, as soon as we find the first number as 0, we need to stop over there. That's why we will be writing break over here. And this else will be shifted by a tab. So I'll be taking a tab over here. And now let's run and see what happens. So if I write over here 12, it says it is not a prime number. And again, at the same time, if I write 37, which is a prime number, and press enter, it says it is a prime number. So I hope, guys, that this is clear that how this program has been created. First of all, we need to take an input from the user. That number is equals to int input, enter a number here. That means we are taking an input in integer. Later, we are taking conditional statement. One conditional statement states that if number is equal to 1, we have to print it is not a prime number, because one number is not a prime number. All the prime numbers start from a range of 2. Now, next condition that we are giving over here is that if number is greater than 1, in that condition, what we will do, we will take a range over here, that for I in range, the range will start from number 2 and goes up to number 11. That is whatever our number is. And if number when divided by I, so what we will be doing, we will be dividing this number with every number in our range and check that if it gives the remainder 0 with any of the number, then it is not a prime number and we'll break the loop over there. Otherwise, what we will be doing, we will be printing it is a prime number. Now, there is one more thing we have written, if number is greater than 1. Now, what will happen if a number is smaller than 1? So, for that, I'll run it and I'll write, let's say, minus 45. So, it won't write anything. For that, what we can do, we can write over here that if number is greater than 1, then we have done all the process. But if number is not greater than 1, that means for else, again, we will print it is not a prime number. So, if the number is not greater than 1, then definitely it's not a prime number. So, negative numbers cannot be a prime number. So, I hope, guys, that this is clear how we have created this program and you guys have no doubts and no questions. And for more such interesting programs, stay connected, guys. Thank you.